Welcome to Zone 5. I'm Dave Baronic, callsign Bio. I have 2,500 flight hours as an F-14 Rio and was a Top Gun instructor for 2.5 years in the 1980s. Recently, I've written several books that describe my experiences as an F-14 Rio and fighter tactics and weapons instructor. My website is topgunbio.com. The Navy started its fighter weapons school in 1969 to improve the training of its fighter pilots and Rios. The program quickly showed its value with a dramatic improvement in the kill ratio over Vietnam. The program has a continuing mission, working to improve U.S. fighter tactics and ensuring that Navy and Marine Corps fighter air crews are among the best trained in the world. I've teamed up with Reflected Simulations to bring the fighter tactics and weapons experience to DCS. The title of this campaign, Zone 5, refers to the maximum afterburner of the engines in the F-14A. You will be using max burner a lot in these engagements. The time is 1987, shortly after F-16s joined the fleet of adversaries. To help introduce the new jet and to further its mission, we arranged a fleet support program, inviting one air crew from two squadrons at Miramar and two squadrons at Oceana for a series of flights. You must be good because you are one of the pilots selected from Miramar. Your name is Lieutenant Jim Bozo Kirby, and your Rio is Lieutenant Frank Jester Honer, and you are from the VF-28 Avengers. This part is important. Your call sign for the duration of this program is Sniper 3. Your wingman, Sniper 4, is from the VF-65 Buzzards. Crew is Pilot Lieutenant Ron Hammer Matthews, and his Rio is Lieutenant Hank Dice Dorman. Sniper 1 comes from the VF-4 Horseman, Lieutenant Kenny Lingus, and Lieutenant Ed Van Klosky. Leading your team is Sniper 2 from VF-221 Goliath. By 11 hops that increase in complexity, starting with 1v1 or 1v1, where you will test your air combat maneuvering skills against a single bandit. You will progress through flights where your section, that is two Tomcats, will perform realistic fighter missions and fight an increasingly challenging bandit presentation. You will then move into division events, where you will be one of four Tomcats against an unknown number of bandits. The program will conclude with two special events that will be briefed later. You'll be flying the F-14 Tomcat, the Navy's premier air-to-air platform. As you learned in the RAG, you can never have enough thrust, so energy management will be important, no matter which Tomcat variant you're flying. Rios will be working their magic with the good old AUG-9. While it's not the newest radar in the world, it has proven capabilities. In keeping with the 1987 setting, we will only use AIM 54s on a few of these flights. In those days, the Phoenix was mostly reserved for fleet air defense, but that was changing. Even with your impressive Tomcat, you must execute precisely. We will challenge you during the intercept phase of the engagement, and we will evaluate all aspects of your performance. In the end, it will not be about winning or losing. Our goal is to make you better training officers so you can increase the combat lethality of your squadron. But we also like to win, so good luck! We spent months putting this program together, and then last week Miramar informed us they will be closed for flight ops for 2 weeks. I don't know if they are installing a new sewer line or testing atomic missiles. Fortunately, our Air Force brothers at Nellis were able to accommodate us. So, welcome to Nellis. You will be spending the next 3 weeks here, and you will spend a lot of that time in Zone 5.
Tower, November Gulf 207, initial for the overhead full stop.
November Gulf 207, Nellis Tower, clear for the overhead runway 21 left.
November Gulf 207,
wings are 20, auto gears down, SASON flaps full, DLC engaged, checked, hooked up, harness lock, boards out, spoiler brakes selected, fuel checked.
refueling. Request rearming.
Copy.
Rearming.
Copy.
Turn on the ground power.
Copy. Refueling complete. Rearming complete. Ground power is now on.
Turn off the ground power.